You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Sunday, the 24th of July, 2022, 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today we are focusing on prayer. What is prayer and what are the benefits of prayer? Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Azuka Ogibonya from Lagos, Nigeria, celebrating her birthday today, text for us the first reading. Gertrude Atieno from Tororo, Uganda, who will be celebrating her birthday on the 29th of this month, text for us the responsorial psalm. Tame Valentine Four from Bamenda, Cameroon, who celebrated his birthday on the 19th of this month, text for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Philemon Aibo from Kaduna Archdiocese in Nigeria as he celebrates his priestly anniversary today. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast, even now, to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak again, but this once. A reading from the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 18, verses 20 to 32. In those days, the Lord said, because the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and their sin is very grave, I will go down to see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry which has come to me. And if not, I will know. So the men turned from there and went towards Sodom. But Abraham still stood before the Lord. Then Abraham drew near and said, will you indeed destroy the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then destroy the place and not spare it for the 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous fare as the wicked. Far be that from you, shall not be judge of all the earth do right. And the Lord said, if I find at Sodom 50 righteous in the city, I will spare the whole place for their sake. Abraham answered, behold, I have taken upon myself to speak to the Lord. I who am but dust and ashes. Suppose 5 of the 50 righteous are lacking. Will you destroy the whole city for lack of 5? And he said, I will not destroy it if I find 45 there. Again he spoke to him and said, suppose 40 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 40, I will not do it. Then he said, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak. Suppose 30 are found there. He answered, I will not do it if I find 30 there. He said, behold, I have taken upon myself to speak to the Lord. Suppose 20 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 20, I will not destroy it. Then he said, Oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak again, but this once. Suppose 10 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 10, I will not destroy it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 138, verses 1 to 2a, 2b, c, d to 3, 6 to 7a, d, 7c to 8. And the response is taken from Psalm 138, verse 3a. And the response is, on the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. I thank you, Lord, with all my heart. You have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I praise you. I bow down towards your holy temple. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. I give thanks to your name for your merciful love and your faithfulness. You have exalted your name and your promise over all. On the day I called, you answered me. You increased the strength of my soul. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. The Lord is high, yet he looks on the lowly, and the haughty he knows from afar. You give me life though I walk amid affliction. You stretch out your hand against the anger of my foes. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. With your right hand, you saved me. The Lord will accomplish this for me. O Lord, your merciful love is eternal. Discard not the work of your hands. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord. On the day I called, you answered me, O Lord.
Second reading. God made you alive with him, having forgiven us all our trespasses. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Colossians chapter 2, verses 12 to 14. Brethren, you were buried with Christ in baptism, in which you were also raised with him through faith in the working of God, who raised him from the dead. And you, who were dead in trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made alive together with him, having forgiven us all our trespasses, having cancelled the bond which stood against us with its legal demands. This he set aside, nailing it to the cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Ask, and it will be given to you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 11, from verse 1 to 13. Jesus was praying in a certain place. And when he ceased, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray as John taught his disciples. And he said to them, When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive each one who is indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation. And he said to them, Which of you who has a friend will go to him at midnight and said to him, Friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine has arrived on a journey, and I have nothing to set before him. And he will answer from within, Do not bother me. The door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything. I tell you, though he will not get up and give him anything because he's his friend, yet, because of his importunity, he will rise and give him whatever he needs. And I tell you, ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. What father among you, if his son asks for a fish, will instead of a fish give him a serpent? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who seek Him? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today I want to bring to our attention that it is World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. We would like to pray for them. We would like to pray for all those who have grown old gracefully, and that they may continue being an example and an inspiration to many of us who are still young. The gospel passage we have today is telling us about prayer. Jesus is in a certain place praying. We are not told if it is on the mountain. No, Jesus was praying everywhere and at any time. So it was not just on the mountain. Some people always believe, no, Jesus always used to go to the mountain to pray. No, here we are just told he was in a certain place praying. And when he finished praying, the disciples went to him, teach us to pray. We have seen how comfortable you are when you are at prayer. We have seen how you look forward to moments of prayer. We have seen how you just want to be with your dad. And we want to have that kind of approach. We don't want to look at prayer as something that we even dread to go back to. No, we want, when we get back from work, to take prayer the way we take that addiction we have to a game. Maybe solitaire, I don't know, maybe Toon Blast. Oh, I'm behind my friends. Oh no, let me go to play that game. We want to have that approach, Lord. We want, when we get back home, say, oh no, I'm behind. I want to update my Lord about this. I want to tell him about this. I want him to know where I am right now. And so they go to Jesus. Teach us to pray as John taught his disciples. Jesus says, you know what? This is how you are to pray. Say, Father, hallowed be your name. You can only say Father if you recognize God to be your Father. You are in a relationship with Him. So when you are praying, start by establishing a relationship. There is no communication if there is no relationship. You can only communicate with the one or to the one you are in relationship. This is exactly what happens. If you have no relationship with somebody, it will be very difficult for you to communicate. So if you are relating to just a general God, you will find it hard to pray, because prayer is communication with your beloved, with your God. I look forward to bending my knees at 3 p.m. when I have to approach a God I relate to as the God of mercy, as the Father of mercy, in the Divine Mercy Chaplet that I pray every day, because it is something that gives me joy. I bend my knees before the God who is merciful, who is kind, who is gentle on me. And I always look forward. When I hear it is 3 p.m., I go to bend my knees. Or if it finds me on the bus, I start right there to pray. Because there is no place for prayer. Every place can be for prayer. But of course, it is good to have a sanctuary, a special corner in your house dedicated to prayer. Because that ambient is very, very important. But what we have here is Jesus being in a certain place, not at the mountain where he used to go. He was in a certain place praying, to tell us any place can be a place for prayer. Even on the bus, even on a bicycle, you can pray. But establish a relationship. Begin by acknowledging that God is your something, our Father. Start by saying, our Father. In that acknowledgement, you are also including other people, because prayer must help you also to understand that there are other people who are also connected to the same God. And so it helps you to become selfless. Not selfish, not individualistic. A prayerful person is one who recognizes God to be a God of all. And since he's a God of all, he's our Father, not my Father, our Father. What in heaven? And since he's our Father, then there are others also who belong to him. And those others I must respect. I must honor. My spouse also belongs to him. I must respect. I must honor. This is something. Prayer must help us to change even as we get engaged into it. And so when you pray, say, our Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. When we talk about his kingdom coming down here on earth, we are saying, Lord, we want all that you are to be here on earth. Your compassion, your goodness, your kindness, and it starts with me. I am going to be compassionate as I pray for your kingdom to come. It must start with me, because I'm your ambassador. And so I want that kingdom which has joy. I will be joyful and I will spread that joy to other people. I want that kingdom which has compassion, and I will be compassionate, and I want that to happen to other people. I want that compassion, and I will be compassionate to other people. Give us each day our daily bread. So after you acknowledge who he is, and after you ask for his kingdom, then you can request for your daily needs. Daily bread here means everything that pertains to your needs. Shelter, food, your health, that is part of your daily bread. Request for all that is connected to your essential needs in your life. And then come to the forgiveness of sins. Forgive us our sins as we forgive everyone who is indebted to us. Your forgiveness should depend on how we forgive others. That's the only part of the prayer that has a condition attached. Forgive us as we forgive. Is that true? Do you really forgive? As we forgive those who trespass against us, do you do that? So prayer must lead us to genuine forgiveness. If you have not reached that genuine forgiveness, you have not been praying. You have to get back to genuine prayer. Genuine prayer transforms the one who prays. And then it is also very effective. It helps also to get that which we are looking for. After telling them how to pray, he comes now to telling them about the fact that prayer is answered. If you pray genuinely, it is answered. That's why he gives that parable of a man who goes by night to go and knock at the door of somebody who is sleeping. It's not like our doors nowadays, which can even be opened automatically, where you just press on a button somewhere and it opens. No, the doors were difficult at that time. They would put logs, and then they would put somebody to sleep close to the door, so that when anyone tries to push it, the log may fall and this person will wake up. So a thief would not just come in anyhow. For security, they had to do all that. Some of the doors didn't have even hinges, and so they had to just put those logs. So this man explained, it is very difficult because I'm already sleeping and my children are also sleeping. So you understand what it means. I have to get up, remove those logs, wake up the children, wake up everybody, and then give you what you are looking for. And Jesus says, if he doesn't do it because of friendship, because you have to establish that relationship, friendship, he's going to give this man because of his persistence. That is what prayer should be like. You persist, and when you persist praying to God, God is going to wake up all the angels and all the saints. They are going to be part of that prayer, and God is going to answer you in abundance. Look at the first reading of today and how Abraham shows us how our prayer life should be like. He took care of those angels, gave them food, and then he escorted them. And as he was escorting them, he remained in the presence of the Lord. He kept praying and started a conversation with the men who were moving towards Sodom and Gomorrah to destroy the land. But Abraham was worried because his blood was there. His nephew Lot was there. And so he started pleading on behalf of the nephew. He became an intercessor, but in a very friendly way, in an informal way, in a kind of conversation, because that's what prayer is. It is a conversation. It is communication. And you have to be comfortable with the one you are communicating. What if you find only 50? Will you destroy those 50 with the unrighteous? No, I won't. Okay. Let's do some bargaining here. We are in business here. This prayer is a kind of business. I want to bargain a little more. I'm looking at the situation of my child. I'm looking at the situation of my spouse. What if you added a few more years? Oh yes, I can add some 10 years to his life. No, what if I beg that you added 15 more years of life? Will that be okay? Oh yes. No. What if I increase to 20? But this is a bargain going down. What if only 10 are found there? Will you destroy? No, I won't destroy for the sake of those 10. And if you look at the way everything is progressing, Abraham has established a relationship. Just like in any business venture, when you establish a relationship with the owner of a shop, you are going to get things at a lower price. And so prayer requires that we get into a relationship. Start by greeting. Greet the one you are talking to. Don't just go straight into praying. Oh, Father God, Heavenly Father, oh, Omnipotent, oh, El Shaddai. No. Greet your God and say, God, good evening. It is your son here. It is your daughter here who recognizes you as the Omnipotent, as the El Shaddai, as Jireh, Shammah. Greet him first. Establish a relationship. Come on, be at home with your God. The reason why many of us don't pray is because we are too formal when we are relating to our God. The reason why many of us don't find any reason to look forward to prayer is because we think God is just too formal. He doesn't want our relationship. He wants us to do things right. And so we end up becoming very removed from our own life of intimacy with God. And we always feel empty when we pray because we are not in a conversation. We are not in a relationship. Abraham is teaching us something. Let us learn something from him. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my day. Your bed.